Divine Truth Spirit Discussions. These are discussions with people who have lived on earth and who have now passed into the spirit world. Jesus speaks to Grace, a woman in the hills, through an intermediary, Anto Klobucar. This discussion was held on the 22nd of April 2014 in Wilkesdale, Queensland, Australia.
Hello.
G'day, Grace.
How are you?
Good, thank you. How about yourself?
I'm not too...
Not too good?
Not too good, no. Definitely not good.
Why is that?
You probably know why that's the case, but... Look, I'm just pissed off with everything. I hate where I am.
Sort of angry.
Can't get out of here.
Yeah.
Fuck, you know, it's just, I'm tired of it, I'm exhausted of it, I'm sick of everything,
yeah.
Everyone around me. I can't just end everything, just,
yeah.
There's no end to this.
There's no end because there's no way of suiciding or anything like that
anymore.
I can't
suicide, I can't do anything, you can't escape, can't hide.
Yeah, it just goes on and on and on.
You just keep getting pulled up in every situation.
Can I first ask you a few questions, just for the sake of the people around us who are here too, just so that we know who we're speaking with. So, Grace, how old were you when you passed into the spirit world?
To be honest, I didn't even want to know how I passed or anything about my passing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not even sure how long I've been here.
Right.
I mean, I
won't be able to help you very much if you're not able to allow yourself to feel about some events in your life. Does that make sense?
But everything hurts so much. I just feel like I'm always feeling hurt and not...
I understand, but it's mostly anger that you're feeling
or
a rebellion against grief. A lot of times you don't want to cry, right?
I mean, I cry. I cry about a lot of things, but...
Yeah, but you cry because you're angry. You cry because things are
I can't
not,
get out of here.
Because they're not what you want them to be. Does that make sense?
Yes.
You're not really crying about what's truthfully happening. You're only crying about the effects of what's happening.
But how do you do that when you're...
That's what I would like to share with you. But to share that with you, we need to examine some of your life on earth to see what it was like. Some of the life that you don't want to remember.
Yeah, I don't want to remember it.
Mm. You see, the way God's made your soul is that your soul will remember everything. Everything. Right from the time you were conceived onwards, your soul has an emotional memory of everything. And from the time you developed your intellect, which usually begins in most children around 1 year of age, from that time on, you are actually now recalling events. And these, or I should say recording events. And these events are being placed within your soul. So in other words... Inside of your soul, there's a record of everything, everything that happened to you in your life. And a lot of what's inside of your soul is emotional because there are emotional things that happened during your life.
But that's the very thing I don't want to know about, you know, my life. My life was shit on earth. It was...
Yeah.
I mean, even God. Like, why the hell? I don't like God either. Like, no. Why would I be here if there was a God?
Yeah. Yeah, no, I understand a lot of your feelings. And that's what I want to be able to help you with. Does that make sense? Can I say some things to you about God firstly?
I'm not sure. you can laugh at it, but...
I'm not laughing. I'm just saying that unless you're willing to feel about...
I feel annoyed about even the word God.
Yeah, I understand that. I do understand that. But I want to point out some things to you about God that you are unwilling perhaps to accept. And while you're unwilling to accept them, you will remain in your current state. I'm assuring you that you will. Because there are certain things that you're blaming God for that God's not to blame for.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Well, how do I know that by just talking about this, is this going to change anything?
Well, it's going to help if you let yourself feel some things, and which you are doing, and that's very good. Right, so it's very good you're allowing yourself to feel what you really feel. But I just need to help you with a few feelings that you're having. And some of them are relating to your life on earth. And some of them are related to your feelings about God. And these are ways that you're preventing certain feelings from flowing. And it's the prevention of feelings from flowing that is causing you to stay in your current condition. Do you see what I'm saying? There are certain things that happened on earth to you and that you chose to do that you need to feel about. And unless you feel about them, you will stay in the same location you currently are.
You understand? I just want to scream when you say the word God, you know, it's...
I understand.
And then you want to talk about it.
Yeah, I understand.
It just defies everything that I...
So tell me why you want to scream.
Fuck, you don't understand. I'm just stuck.
Yes. And you don't believe God wants to get you out of there?
No. There's no help, you know, where are these bloody pearly gates?
There is help, but it's just not the help that the Christian religion described.
Fuck Christianity, fuck everything. You know, you don't understand.
Yeah.
You're stuck here. Where's all this
support? I do understand because I've been in the spirit world and I've observed many, many millions of people in your condition. So I do understand. I do understand.
But have you ever been in this situation?
No.
You know,
because I chose differently on earth, and this is what I'm trying to say to you.
Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not even confident about this person who brought me here, you know. And
who's the person who brought you here? You tell me about the person who brought you here.
Well, he brought me here.
Yep.
He reassured me that you'd be kind to me.
Yep.
That you have some answers.
Yes.
You know, definitely, to the questions that I've...
I definitely have answers to your questions.
And it's taken a while for him to get to me.
Yep. And at last you've allowed yourself to talk to him.
Yeah, I...
Yep. Well. And he's been trying to guide you for a long time, yes?
That's what he says.
Yeah. So he's been trying to help you.
Well, he's been trying to help us and me and, you know, a few of us.
And he hasn't been successful until now?
No. He said he's desired to.
So what was stopping him from helping you?
Me.
Yes.
And that's what he said.
That's correct. So the next question really is, what inside of you was stopping him, do you think?
I never thought of it.
Yeah.
Well, why would anyone come talk to me if I'm this angry, I guess?
Well, that's one thing, isn't it? Obviously, if we're very angry and all we want to do is...
And I wanted to harm males.
Yes. So there's another reason why he found it very difficult. Yeah.
And I didn't want to know anyone, really.
Yeah.
I just wanted to.
To be alone, but you also wanted to be without the misery. And it's very hard to be both of those things in the spirit world location where you live.
It's impossible.
Correct.
You know, you're in this feeling and...
Correct.
It's almost like I've got a bit of a reprieve now and I don't know why, but...
Well, that's because I'm speaking with you and also there's some love present. And there's not been very much love present where you are.
No, there's no love. No. There's no love around.
Have you met other people where you live in the
spirit? Yeah, we're all pretty much the same.
Yeah, all angry.
We can't get away from each other. We're trying to
push each other away and can't get away from each other. And
you only get
angry.
Each other get away. And it's more like they camp close.
Yeah, and you're more and you're angry with men.
Oh,
all of you angry
fuck
with men.
Fuck men. I really despise men.
Yeah. And so it's very good you've had the courage to even come and talk to me on the word of a man. That's pretty brave, considering how much you find men difficult.
It's taken a while.
Yeah.
It's not an easy process.
No.
He says it's not an easy process.
Correct. It's not an easy process. But I'm prepared to answer any of the questions you have, and then hopefully I can help you a little bit to get into a different place where it's not so bad.
Why are you so loving as a male?
Well, the main reason why anybody's not loving is because they chose to be not loving. And the main reason why somebody is loving is because they chose to be loving. Does that make sense? And in my life, I've always tried to choose to be loving. So that's the reason why I'm loving. But there's also a second reason that's even more important. That is because I've chosen to be loving, I've chosen to receive some of God's love as well. And as a result of that, God's love transformed me into being more loving.
For that.
So that God's love has helped me a lot to be more loving.
But there's a presumption there that means that I've chosen not to be.
Correct. It's not a presumption.
But why are you so blasé in that statement?
I'm not blasé about it. It's a very important that you understand the reasons why you're in your current condition. And all I want to do is be honest with you about it. Does that make sense? So understand that what I'm talking about is not a judgment. It's just it's something that we need to look at. I need to explain to you how the spirit world works. Does that make sense? Okay. If you understand how the spirit world works, you may understand better why I've said these things to you.
Yeah, I don't understand why I'm here.
Okay. The way the spirit world works is that God has created locations in the spirit world that are the same as our own condition of love. In other words, the more love we have from God's perspective, the better and happier the location. And the less love we have from God's perspective, the more desperate and unhappy is the location. Does that make sense?
So that would mean I'd have to look at the measurement of love.
Yeah, God's measurement of love and not your own. The reason why you're so angry is because you're looking at your own measurement of love and not God's.
Yeah, I thought I was loving.
Yes, I agree. You thought you were loving. And you thought that what you did on earth was loving. But you are not judging it by God's standards. You're judging it by your own standards.
But we...
And the location where you are now is the result of you loving from your own standards, not from God's standards. Does that make sense?
Well, I can't deny that fact.
Yeah.
If that's true.
If it's true, you can't deny it. But the key is whether it is true or not, isn't it? That's the key, really.
Well, I'm not accepting... I'm finding it hard to accept that I wasn't a loving person and then that's
well, let me
here.
Well, let me show... I can prove to you this by, if you're willing to... I'm going to ask a friend of mine to come to you. Right? Can you see the spirit who's coming in front of you now?
Mm-hmm.
They've toned down their own brightness so that you can see them and you can tolerate their company. Okay? They seem to be quite a positive person, don't they?
Yes.
Okay. Now, on earth, some men abused you, didn't they?
Yes.
Yeah. Just temporarily, what I'm going to suggest is that we take you to those men and show you where they are. It's going to be hard for you emotionally, but I want to illustrate something through taking you there. You're not going to be there permanently. We'll bring you back to where you are now, right? And in fact, we do not want you to stay there permanently. We certainly don't want you to stay there abusing them, if that's what you're thinking of doing.
Yeah, how'd you know that?
What we want to do instead is just to show you where they are. Is that okay with you?
Yeah. Okay.
So it'll just be a quick showing you where they are and then we'll come back to the location where you currently are. All right? Okay, so let's do that. Now you need to come back. So what do you notice?
I just get very angry.
Yeah, but where are they?
They're worse than I am.
They're worse than you are.
They look horrible.
Yes. So they're in a worse condition than you are.
So they should be.
Well, yes. They should be because of what they did, right? But can you see, if they are in a worse position than you are, then it means from God's point of view, they did worse things than you did.
Yeah.
Does that make sense to you?
Yes. Oh, I see.
You see what I'm getting at?
So I'm not in a place like they are, so...
You're not in a place like they are, so you didn't do as bad things as they did. But the place is still sad and it's still depressing and it's still hard to be there, isn't it?
Extremely.
Yeah. So that means that from God's perspective, you should be where you are.
Oh.
And it's based on you've been basing everything on your definition of love, but God bases everything on God's definition of love.
How did I get it so wrong?
Well, on the earth, it's quite easy to get it wrong. You know, like we're brought up with a false definition of love. most of our parents don't know how to love. A lot of times they teach us things are loving while at the same time they're belting us and abusing us. And, you know, most parents are violent towards their children and they call that love. They say, in fact, I only am doing this because I love you. And none of this is true, of course, right? So we grow up on earth with a very distorted viewpoint of love. That makes sense?
Made me feel, think about my parents.
Yeah, they didn't treat you very well, did they?
No one treated me well.
No.
That's the thing.
No.
And I don't understand. Yeah. Life was hard. It was hard for all of us.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, can I just make one suggestion that's going to be challenging, though? Because life was hard for all of you, and life was hard for you, Grace, I understand that it was on earth, you then chose to do some things to other people, which were also quite hard.
And I realised that because things get worse down here.
Correct. And remember, even after you passed into the spirit world initially, you tried to harm people on earth.
Yeah, I did. Every person I could get my hands on.
Yes, even people who didn't harm you.
No, I didn't know these people.
Yeah.
But damned if I was going to let them harm others.
Yeah. So you harmed them instead.
No.
Can you see that?
Yeah, I did. I acknowledge that.
Yeah. And as a result of harming these people, your condition of love degraded. And the reason why you harmed them was because you were unwilling to feel your own pain, and instead you wanted to create pain in others.
That's all I wanted to, that's all I could feel.
Correct. You see, if you had chosen to not create pain in others rather than, and just feel your own pain, you wouldn't be in the condition where you are now.
But how do you do that? You've got this overarching feeling, you know.
Correct. So how do you feel feelings? How do you feel feelings without hurting other people? That's the question.
Yeah, how do you?
Well, that requires a lot of bravery and courage on your part. You see, it requires that you allow yourself to feel your feelings without expressing the desire to harm somebody else.
Yeah, I don't.
Now, God can help you do that. And there are people like your friend who brought you to me who can help you do that. But you've only wanted to harm other people up until now. And that's caused your own harm. It's made your own condition worsen. You see, what happened was other people harmed you, and then you decided that instead of feeling that harm, you would harm other people.
Yeah, I wanted justice.
Well, it's not justice.
But isn't that a principle of love?
No, what's really justice, if you think of it from a purely a justice perspective, would be that you harmed the very people who harmed you. But you didn't just harm the people who harmed you. You harmed other people who you didn't even know.
Yeah, I harmed the abomination that was harming all other women.
Well, you harmed men.
Yes.
And many of those men weren't harmful to women. Many of them weren't. Many of those men were nice men.
How would I have known?
Well, you weren't sensitive enough to know because you were so enraged that you didn't know how to tell the difference. You think back at the time. You didn't know how to tell the difference. You just decided that 50% of the world's population needed to be harmed. And you decided to have a vendetta against 50% of the world's population. And so you decided to harm them.
Yeah.
But a lot of those men didn't harm women. A lot of those men were nice to women. A lot of those men were kind.
I believe they would.
No, it's in their nature. Right. No, that's your belief. And it's not in men's nature. It's in men's injuries to do that. I don't feel like doing it. The man who's helping you doesn't feel like doing that. So no. How can you say it's in man's nature? The man who's channeling you doesn't want to harm you. So there's three men here in the room who don't want to harm you. So can you see the justification is false?
I can see the logic in it.
Yeah. And you did it because you just didn't want to feel your own pain about being harmed by men. And it wasn't just all men, it was specific men who harmed you, wasn't it?
Yes.
You know?
It was my dad.
It was your dad, yeah? It was primarily your dad, but then there was a few...
And my brothers.
...men in your life, yeah?
Yeah.
Who harmed you, yeah? Yeah. And as a result, you decided that you were going to harm all men. Yeah. Now, if it was just, you would have only decided that you were going to harm the men who harmed you.
But I don't understand why I did that. It just, it sort of overtook me.
Well, it overtook you because you didn't want to feel how you'd been harmed. You didn't want to cry about it. You didn't want to feel powerless and weak. You didn't want to just let the tears go, you know what I mean? And you decided instead that the best course of action would have been to harm another. And a lot of these other people were men who didn't deserve any harm from anybody. And many of them, if you look back at them, were probably quite helpful to women, and you tried to harm them. And many of them got worse towards women after you harmed them. Can you see that?
Now I'm being blamed for that too.
No, I'm just saying that many of, I'm just saying the truth of what happened. You look back at some of the men that you harmed, and you can see that after you harmed them, they did get worse towards other women.
Yeah, they did.
So how can you say that you weren't a part of creating it harder for other women? See, if you hadn't harmed those men, they may not have made the decisions and choices they made. They are making the same, in fact, decision and choice you made. And that is, the decision you made was men harmed you, so you decided to harm men. The men that you harmed decided to harm you or to harm other women. Can you see the cycle? Somebody's got to stop the cycle.
I never saw it that way.
Yeah. If somebody doesn't stop the cycle, you'll just have one generation of men harming women, the next generation of women harming men, and the next generation of men harming women, and so forth and so forth, and you just get this continuous cycle of pain in between the two genders that doesn't need to be there as long as both genders stop harming each other. Do you follow me?
But it's, you know, it is interesting. I can see it.
Yeah. But you can still feel the feeling in you, right?
Yeah, the moment I passed.
Yeah.
So I had the opportunity then. It's just join in with the force and off we went.
Yeah, because there was a lot of other women around you by that stage who were angry about what was happening to you, and they just helped you, if you think about it, they helped you make this choice to go and harm a whole heap of men, a lot of these men who were not harmful to women.
Yeah, I mean, there's no consideration of...
Who they were
or...
If they were just open...
Or they'd even harm other women. Like, I didn't... That wasn't my intention.
No, but that's the result. You see?
That makes me feel worse.
Well, I'm not trying to make you feel worse. What I'm trying to help you see is that from God's perspective, that's not love.
No, I mean, by any stretch of the imagination, what I did's not loving. No.
Correct. And where you are is the result of your not loving others.
But
so does that help explain why you are where you are?
As well as that I've what, caused the harm of others.
You have caused the harm of others, and that's
indirectly
why...
Indirectly as well.
Indirectly and directly. So you caused the harm of men, but indirectly, because you harmed those men, they then chose to harm other women. And so indirectly, you've also caused the harm of other women.
I didn't want to do that.
No, I know you didn't want to at the time, but you weren't reasoning about the issue at the time either, if you think about it.
No, I wasn't.
You were only interested in denying your own emotions, your own grief about what had happened to you. You wanted to be enraged with somebody. And so you decided to take it out on people, many of whom you had no reason to take it out on. But by then, you were embroiled in this group action with your other sisters in the spirit world who all feel the same way. And that's why you are all where you currently are. Does that make sense? From God's perspective, that is not loving. And where you currently are is exactly where God feels you need to be, that matches your condition of love.
All right, you've proved your point.
Okay. So the next question is, how do you get out of there?
Hmm.
Is that the next question?
Oh, yeah, I want it.
You want to get out of there, don't you?
Well, No, maybe you can take a step back.
You don't want to go lower. You want to go to a happier place.
What's happened?
So what's the step back you want to take?
What has occurred for him to turn up? For me to be able to talk to you, and what's changed?
What changed is that there is a little bit of a shift in your attitude towards men. Can you remember the event that triggered it?
Yeah, I started to feel that I'm doing something bad.
Correct. You started to see that harming men wasn't the answer, and in fact it was causing more of your own pain, if you remember, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Every time you harmed another man, you had more pain to feel, didn't you?
This pain is unbearable.
Yeah, it is hard.
If people
knew, they wouldn't do it, would they?
No.
It's terrible pain, and most people have no idea, because it's all emotional pain. Most people have no idea that when they take the actions they take on earth and in the spirit world, that they're actually causing their own degradation into emotional pain. And it is hellish, isn't it? Like, it feels like hell.
It's just instant.
Yeah.
It's unbearable.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't understand. Like, it's almost like you get conditioned. You're okay with it to a certain point, and just things get worse.
Correct. And then you harm more people, and then it gets worse. And eventually, the pain gets so great that you have to stop. And that's what happened to you.
Okay.
The pain got so great, the pain of harming men, one man after another and after another man, making them feel bad emotionally and so forth, and all the actions that you were taking in order to hurt them, the pain of doing that became so great for you that you stopped.
But I could see in her eyes, she was so angry as well.
Who are you talking about now?
The person I was helping
harm. To harm men.
Yeah.
The person on earth you were helping to harm men.
Yeah.
Yep. You were using a woman on earth to harm other men.
That's right.
Yep.
And
she was becoming darker.
She was becoming
as well.
Like us.
Yeah. Yep.
On earth.
Yeah. Yeah. Because she was having this rage as well, not wanting to feel her own feelings. Same thing. So she's darkening her condition. And she'll probably, when she arrives in the spirit world, perhaps be even in a darker condition than yourself.
It worries me.
Yeah, it is a concern, because you've been a part of that as well.
Oh.
Does that make sense?
How do I talk to her?
Well, the key is to try to help her, like, release the pain she feels, rather than taking that pain out on other people.
I feel so anxious now, talking about it.
What I need to do, though, is share one more thing with you.
Okay.
Before you get too anxious about everything and worried, we need to talk more about the situation. Does that make sense?
Yeah, okay.
The reason why you stopped doing this was because you felt so much pain that it became unbearable for you.
Okay, yes, I can see that.
So in a way, it was sort of like a selfish decision. You decided to stop harming other people because it hurt too much.
If you put it that way, yes.
But there was no other motivation, was there?
No.
You didn't do it for some pure motive. You did it because it stopped harming you.
I'd like to say.
It's okay to be honest. Like, I'm not judging you. It's okay to be honest. I'm just trying to help you see the direction of where you... I'm trying to help you see the direction of your life. Does that make sense?
Okay.
So if we look at... There was a lot of harm perpetrated towards you from men, and it was only a few men, but it was pretty bad harm perpetrated by men in your life on earth.
Okay, I agree.
Yep.
The
when you passed, you were very, very angry, and you didn't want to feel your sadness about it. You didn't want to feel your grief.
No.
You didn't want to feel how frightened they made you feel. You didn't want to feel any of those feelings.
No.
So what you decided to do then was join up with a group of women and use another woman on earth to harm other people. And you weren't concerned about harming all people. You wanted to just harm other men. And it didn't matter what men they were, did it? It
No.
didn't matter whether they were nice men or not a nice man. In your mind, there was no such thing as a nice man.
Yeah, they're all the same.
They're all the same. They all want sex, and that's one thing, and they all take it, and they're all abusive, and they're all violent. And you just wanted to get angry with them all.
Hmm.
Isn't that right?
And then all these women are angry about that.
Yep. And all of you degraded as you did it. you will now feel more pain than when you passed.
Yes, that's true.
Isn't it? Mm. So all of your conditions degraded as you did this.
So that's the result of what we were doing.
That was the result of what you were doing. And the reason why it degraded was because from God's point of view, that was not love.
But me stopping is now loving.
It's more loving, certainly. Or attempting to. Yeah, yeah, attempting to stop, that's more loving, definitely. I agree. It would be even better if you decided to feel some of the emotions that caused you to do it and feel sorry for what you did, because that would cause you to be even more loving.
But how would I do that?
That means, firstly, going back to the reasons why you did it.
Which is the very thing you asked me.
Correct. I have to take you back to your life on Earth.
It's like a puzzle you're unwinding.
That's correct. That's what I'm trying to do. You see, you have a lot of pain and sadness and fear.
It's a different type of pain.
It is. It's not a pain where you're going to go out and take it out on other people. It's a pain where you can feel, you can sort of sit with it and feel it, isn't it? Can you see that?
But it,
it's a different type of pain, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm uncomfortable with it.
No. That's why you've gone out and attacked other people, because you're not comfortable feeling this kind of pain. And what I'm suggesting to you is that if you chose to feel this kind of pain instead, then God can help you go through the process of being sorry for what you've done to other people to avoid this pain. You see, every bit of badness that ever happens on earth is a direct result of somebody trying to avoid their own pain.
That sounds so weird.
It's true when you think about it, though, isn't it?
Yeah, in my case, it's true.
Yeah. If you ask all your friends there,
yeah, they're all the same. We're all the same. Yeah.
Yeah. You think about it. Every one of you took actions to harm men because you had been harmed by men. And why do you think those men chose to harm you? Because they had been harmed by women, and they chose to harm women. Does that make sense?
Yeah, but I never would have looked at it that way.
So you get this cycle happening where people want to abuse other people and harm other people, either just because they can or because they have been personally harmed.
But this pain that I'm denying,
mm-hmm.
would that obviously be bigger than the pain that I've felt this entire time?
Like, yeah, the pain that you're denying is smaller, actually.
How can that be?
Because the pain where you were harmed by others, right? That pain, that grieving-based pain, is actually smaller from God's perspective inside of you than the harm you have perpetrated towards others is.
But didn't that drive my action?
No, it was your avoidance of it that drove your action.
Okay, that's different.
That's different. You see, you chose to avoid feeling that pain, the smaller pain, and instead you've now created a larger pain to feel.
So why do I, is it feel that this pain is huge?
Because the pain now is huge. You have harmed other people, and so you're going to have pain to go through because you've harmed other people. Does that make sense? So this is the sad truth. The sad truth is if right at the beginning when you passed into the spirit world, you decided to not harm another man, you would have had just a little bit of pain in comparison to what you have now to feel.
But I felt I was damned. So damn it if I do, damn it if I don't.
No, but it's just a feeling you have. It's not true. It's not the way God feels about you. It's just a feeling you had from what people told you.
So what does God feel about me?
God loves you, actually.
But if you love me, how does that stand to reason?
If he loved you, keep going with that.
If you love me, then why would I have turned up here? Oh.
Yes. Can you see?
Because of something I love my head.
Because you chose to be unloving to others. That's why you've turned up here. You see, if it was just the harm that had been given to you and no harm of others, and you'd perpetrated no harm, you would have ended up in a better location. Does that make sense? And this is the sad thing about joining up with a team of other people who are all angry, is they eventually influence you to take actions that are as angry as well, and eventually it causes the degradation of your condition.
It seems so simple now that you explained it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so where to from here?
So where to from here?
I don't want to go back.
No, no, of course not. I understand that. Where to from here is two places. There's repentance and then there's forgiveness. So let me describe the relationship between these two things, right? Mm. And then what I would like to do is introduce you to a third thing, which will help you with the first two. Is that okay with you?
Okay.
Okay. So have you heard of the word repentance before?
Yes.
What do you think it means?
To forgive.
No. What does repentance mean? You think about the word repentance.
Well, I always felt, I thought from the teachings that we had learnt.
Yeah.
Is to allow the sins to come out from us, from within us.
Okay, so basically you could say repentance is acknowledging your own sins and wanting to change them.
But I did confessions, you know.
Yeah, no, but see...
What type of sins are you talking about? You're talking about the sins...
Of harming other people.
Oh, right.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
So that's the sins that we're talking about here. Mm. So repentance is where you feel sorry for what you've done.
And I haven't done that.
No, you haven't done that.
I don't feel...
And if part of you sort of feels like, why should I have to be sorry, right?
Yeah, that's right. You know me too well.
Well, it's easy to feel your feelings. Mm. The second thing is forgiveness. What do you think forgiveness is?
Well, that's a hard one. Not
well, forgiveness is where you forgive somebody else...
For the action they've done to me.
For the action they've done to you, or forgive yourself for the action you did to you. Because sometimes we do things to ourselves.
Which I'll need to do in this case, won't I?
Correct. You know?
But how do I do that?
Exactly. That's the question, isn't it? The question is, how do I repent and how do I forgive? And can you see they're different? Like, repentance is aimed towards all the people you've harmed. Mm. And that's repentance. And forgiveness is aimed towards all the people who have harmed you.
I've got a lot more repentance to do than to forgive.
I don't know about that, no. Because the reality is you were harmed quite a lot, right, as you know. So you'll find forgiveness just as hard as repentance. And in fact, the whole reason why you're in the position you're in right now is because you chose to not forgive. See, if you'd chosen to forgive your dad and your brothers for what they did to you, right?
That answers my question.
Rather than harming somebody else, then you wouldn't be in the position you're in now.
Okay.
Can you see that?
Yeah.
Now, repentance and forgiveness are emotional processes. They require you to feel something. In other words, you can't just say, I'm sorry. You know, there's a lot of people on earth who say, I'm sorry, when the feeling coming from them is they're not sorry at all, right?
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah.
I've done that.
Yeah. And there's also a lot of people who say to other people on earth, oh, I forgive you, when really by themselves, they go, oh, I hate that person, I want to hurt them.
Yeah.
Right. And they haven't forgiven at all, have they?
No.
No.
Because so in your heart, you feel.
It's got to be a feeling, you see. Mm. So it's going to require you becoming sensitive to feelings.
And not respond to them.
And not respond to them. Not act upon them.
Act. All right.
See, what you've done up to now is you've been sensitive to your feeling, but you've chosen to deny the feeling and you've become sensitive instead to the rage. And then what you've done is decided to act upon the rage, and then in acting upon the rage, you went and hurt somebody else, lots of other people. People who hadn't harmed you, you decided to harm, and you chose to use a woman on earth to be the instrument of your harm of others. Yeah?
Yeah.
Mm.
It's a lot to take in.
It is. Now, the way to help you do this is to understand one thing, and that is that God loves you. Now, that's going to be pretty hard for you to understand.
That's challenging.
Because all of your life on earth, nobody really loved you.
No.
So you don't really know what love is.
I don't have felt a demonstration of that.
You haven't felt a demonstration of God's love for you?
No.
Do you want to feel one now? Because I can help you go through an experience that will help you feel God's demonstration of love for you. See, this is where sometimes you wonder, Can you see how you're exercising your will to not receive any love?
Yeah.
So how can you... See, God's going to honour that will of yours. See, if you don't want to receive love from God, God's going to say, okay, okay, you don't have to have it.
But you're saying God's love is available.
God's love is available. God's offering it to you, yes. Because you're angry, you don't want to have it.
No.
But what I'm suggesting is that we can go through an experiment which will let you receive it, but it has to be a sincere experiment which will let you receive it. And then you'll see what you've been missing out on. Well, the feeling, it's firstly important for you to understand that the feeling that you have about God is driven totally by your parents. You think about what they taught you. What did they teach you about God?
It's punishing.
That God's a punishing God?
Yeah.
That God's violent?
Yeah, abuses kids.
Abuses children? And in fact, does that for the child's own good? That's what the parents...
That I was supposed to get that. I was...
Yeah, that they would... God's instrument doing it for God.
Hmm.
Yeah, all false. The whole lot of that's false.
But he said it in the name of God.
Yeah, that's right. So you were a member of a Christian family who abused their children and then sexually abused you, right? And they did it in the name of God.
And yet they're saying all that crap at church and...
Yep.
You know, they have all those gatherings and...
Yep. Yeah, they were all false, weren't they? And that's why the people who abuse you, your dad and your brothers, who you went to visit, are in a darker condition than you. Can you see? Because what they did was worse than what you did.
But
and they deserve to be there because of what they did.
But how could they talk about God in that way if they didn't know themselves?
Well, it doesn't matter how they talked about God. They knew what they were doing to you was wrong. Anybody would know that.
And why wasn't I protected? Yeah.
Well, there was attempts to protect you. One of the man who's with you, who brought you to me, has tried to protect you most of your life. Right, so there's been attempts to protect you. But unfortunately, sometimes the earth life is so abusive that it's very, very hard for spirits to help people on earth to help you.
See, why God? You can feel it.
Well, the question you have is, why did God allow that?
Yeah, why did he create a system for that to be?
No, he created free will, where people could do what they want.
And they did what they wanted.
And they did what they wanted. That's the problem. So the real problem is not that God created free will, but people decided to use free will. It's a bit like if I give you a knife, when you're angry, you're just as likely to stab someone with it than you were to eat something with it.
In a way, I did the same thing, yeah?
Correct.
Hmm.
You see, this is what you need to see.
So I can't see what happened to them. As to why they did what they did to me.
No, you can't. And there's reasons why they did it. But at this point in time, honestly, there's little to be gained by examining those reasons. Does that make sense? They are where they are because they deserve to be there because that's God's measure of love.
I thought I did something wrong.
Yeah, well, they tried to tell you that you did something wrong, but that's not true. From God's perspective, that's not true. No person who is ever abused... is the cause of the abuse. If a person chooses to abuse you, it is because there is something faulty inside of their reasoning, not yours. There's something wrong with them, not you.
But I can't negate the feeling that I feel that way.
I understand. So you need to feel these feelings, right? Without doing something about them. See, these are feelings that you need to let go of. Once you let go of them, you'll be willing to connect to God a bit. God's got love to give you.
But I don't know. I don't feel I deserve it. So.
Well, you do deserve it. So even though you don't feel you deserve it, you still deserve it. God wants to give love to all of God's children. Does that make sense?
But is that
whether we deserve it or not, God still wants to give it. Because God's kind.
Is that a selfish thing, though?
What's that?
To now seek God's love given everything I've done to others.
Not at all. Not at all. God's going to require that you go through repentance about everything you've done to harm others. And God's going to require at some point forgiveness of you. In other words, where you forgive the people who harmed you. So it's going to be a tough process. But at least through it, you'll have God's love. And you'll know it. You'll be able to feel God's love if you let yourself feel it.
Okay.
So what I'm getting to is the third point I was raising. And that is... the way to feel God's love. And it's really, really simple.
Is it?
Yeah. You say, God, if you've got love to give to me, I would like to feel it. And you need to be sincere about it.
How do you do that?
So you let yourself have a feeling, because you haven't got a feeling yet. You just said it, but you haven't got a feeling yet. Do you want to receive God's love? How do you feel?
Oh, that's a hard one, given I...
At the moment, you're not really sure, are you?
No, because... No.
Because of all your false beliefs about God, right?
Yeah, my anger.
But remember that it was all those nasty people on earth who taught you those false things, and maybe all of them are wrong. So maybe you could say something like this to God. If you're not the kind of person that my parents and everyone else told me you were on earth, I would like to receive some love for you, and you need to have a feeling come from you about that towards God.
Say that again.
So say to God, if you're the kind of person that is like the person that my parents told me you were, I don't want to receive anything from you.
I don't want anything.
No. Is that not true?
Yes.
Okay. But if God's not the person who is like you were taught, what would you like then?
No. Just to be loved and cared.
Yeah. So feel that feeling and ask God, if you're not the kind of person that's like my parents taught me, I'd like to have that feeling from you. That's it. Feel that.
I didn't know anyone could love me.
Yeah.
I'll be here for years, Croc.
Now I'd like to show you something.
You've shown me so much.
Mm-hmm. There's one more thing I'd like to show you. You look around now where you are.
Oh, wow. Everything's much brighter around here.
Everything's different, isn't it?
Yeah, I can actually feel more myself.
Yeah?
There's more people around here.
There's more people?
Around all of us.
Yeah? There's more love where you are now, isn't there?
Hmm.
Can you see the benefits of doing what I just suggested?
Oh, that was instant.
That's instant, yeah. And that's because of God's love as it operates on the soul is instant. There's an instant change. Everything around you changes once you receive it. Now, I'm not saying that you're going to be able to avoid these issues of repentance and forgiveness, because you still need to let yourself feel about all those things. But the more of God's love you feel, the easier it will become to feel about repentance and forgiveness.
Mm.
Does that make sense?
This is so breathtaking.
Mm.
Not just as in...
Oh. Emotionally overwhelming.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Let's redefine everything I know.
Yeah. Well, the big lesson is this. The position where you are in the spirit world is dependent upon the love that you have. And God's trying to teach you about love. But it's not your definition of love that he's trying to teach you about. He's trying to teach you about his definition of love.
So all these other people are learning that? Correct. Or have learned it?
They've learned some aspect of love. And the brighter the person, the more they've learnt about love. Does that make sense? So you notice how some people around you still are brighter than others?
Hmm.
Well, they've learnt more about love than the others.
They've learnt how to forgive others, correct, even if they harmed them.
Correct. Which is what you need to learn, isn't it?
Hmm.
You need to learn to go through this emotional process of letting go of what people have done to you without choosing to harm another.
Hey, some of them have been harmed more than me.
Correct.
And they're like this.
Correct. So they've gone through lots of emotion to get where they are. But you can see the result. It's a happy result, right?
Hmm.
So why wouldn't you want to do it? It makes sense, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. Don't want to be down there anymore.
No.
Gee, they've got a lot to share.
Now, you ask your friend where you are now.
I'm in another space.
You're in another space in the first sphere of the spirit world, it's called.
Hmm.
But it's a completely different space. And
if
we went from 0 to 100 in the first sphere of the spirit world, and that encompassed the whole sphere, ask your friend where you were when we began this conversation.
I was in around the 10.
Number 10 of 100.
Hmm.
And where are you now?
In the 30s.
Yeah.
So there's so many other homes.
There's so many other homes, the surroundings completely different. And even though it's still fairly dark, it's a little, it's greyish now, isn't it? You can see some things, the starting of colour is forming.
Yes.
Whereas before you weren't seeing any colour at all. You weren't seeing anything, were you?
No, I couldn't see anything, I was just getting darker.
Just dark, dark.
Now couldn't feel myself that much.
You can see things a bit now, can't you?
Mm.
The outline of shapes and things like that, and
I'm feeling lighter too.
Yeah, exactly.
Warmer in the heart.
Yeah. 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 If you decide to go back and start harming other people again, you'll go back down to where you were.
Oh, no, I'm not going there. Sorry.
Yeah.
It's taken me this long to get here.
Yeah. Long time. Can I ask you now a little bit about your life?
Hmm.
Do you remember when you were died? What the year was? This will help you remember some things. And it's okay to remember things.
Well, do I have to?
Well, no, you don't have to do anything, but it will just help you go through emotions that you need to go through. And remember, every time you go through these emotions and you long for more of God's love, you'll be in a better place. So this is the way to have more love in your soul. To let go of the harm that's been done to you. Does that make sense? And all of the harm that happened to you happened before you passed. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So that's the area of the life that you need to have a feel about.
I died when I was young.
Yeah.
As a girl.
Yeah. And can you see when you passed into the spirit world, you were pretty easily influenced by other women?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you see that a lot of the things you chose to do, you did because they wanted you to do it?
Yeah, they said they'll protect me this way.
Yeah, that's right.
I wouldn't be harmed if I harm others first.
Yeah, that's what they told you. So they told you a heap of false things, didn't they?
Yeah, they did.
Yeah. And, you know, if you hadn't have been harmed yourself, you probably wouldn't have believed them.
But no, I never associate with people like this.
Yeah, but because you'd been harmed yourself, you believed them. Yeah. Can you see, you can forgive yourself to a degree, can't you, there?
Yeah.
For why you chose to do what you did.
I can see it's all wrong, it's everything.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Oh, I wasn't like this on that.
No, no. Well, you were frightened and scared and you were quite little on earth, right?
What are you supposed to do?
Well, from God's perspective, parents are supposed to love their children and not do what your parents did. Right, and that's why your parents are in a darker condition than you were, even after you've harmed other people. Because your parents caused a lot of this damage. And they, of course, deserve to be where they currently are.
Why didn't Mum protect me?
Why didn't
Mum protect me?
Well, because your mum, also had some conflicting emotions about protecting you. She was scared herself, but she was also quite angry with you, right? So she felt competitive with you, and she felt those kind of feelings. So
because Dad always had affection for me.
Exactly. Well, Dad, when you said has affection, it was very abusive affection. Yeah. So it wasn't real affection.
He scared me.
Yeah, he was scary and violent and sexually violent. But
I knew when he was looking at me.
Yeah.
What was coming.
Yeah. But your mum was almost jealous of you for your dad being like that. So rather than your mum choosing to protect you, she thought you deserved what you got. So that wasn't very nice of your mum, and that's why your mum was even in a darker condition than you were.
But why didn't I attack her and women? Why?
Because you didn't see her as the cause of your problem.
Oh.
You saw men as the cause of your problem.
Wow. It's amazing when you go back into these feelings. So much gets revealed.
Mm. Now have a look at your surroundings again.
Now I'm crying about that.
Exactly. Yeah. So remember we asked your friend to tell you from 0 to 100 where you were, and you started at 10.
Well, I just keep on climbing.
And you were 30, and now where are you?
I'm climbing into the 40s.
Yeah, so you're up near the 40s. Just by feeling some feelings that you need to feel, right?
But I feel much younger.
You will. You will also look much younger. One day you have a good look in the mirror and you'll actually look much younger as well. All right. Now, this is the process God designed.
But I'm so scared.
So you've got to learn.
I'm a very... It's different. I was so... Oh, my voice has changed.
You remember you were all gruff and manly when we began.
Yeah.
And now you're starting to sound a bit more womanly, right?
Oh, I'm so amazed.
Yeah.
I just want to keep crying.
So now that I've explained to you how to grow and how to change and how you can receive God's love, my suggestion to you is to keep doing those things, even though it's painful.
Yeah, I will.
Make sense?
Yes.
And you have the help of your friend, the man who brought you to me. What was his name?
Jose.
Jose? So you have Jose's help. He's always wanted to help you.
Yeah, he has.
Yeah. And you have his help. He can explain to you what to keep doing.
He was even abused, wasn't he?
Okay, exactly. So he understands what it feels like, right?
Yeah, he does.
Oh. Yeah. So my suggestion to you now is just to keep doing that. Right? And you will keep progressing. And you'll never have to go back to where you started. You'll never have to go back to the number 10 in that first beer, because that's a pretty painful place, isn't it? Yeah. You remember you have people who love you and God loves you. And it doesn't matter what your mum and dad said about God, they were lying to you. And they used that all as an excuse to hurt you. That's what they did. They use that all as an excuse to harm you. And you remember that God's good. And if you ever, never forget that God's good. And it's only people who chose to be bad that have caused this harm.
I feel like I just want to help other people.
Yeah, you'll get to the point where you'll be able to help other people. You first need to learn how to do that. And that's all. That's all good. That's all good. You want to teach people to do the right thing instead of teaching them to do the wrong thing like you were doing before, right? And one of the persons you'll want to help is the lady on earth who you had been using to harm men. You want to help her too at some point. But these are all things that you can do in good time. That makes sense?
Every time you talk, another feeling.
Yeah, it's good. Don't be afraid of the feelings. They're all okay. You don't have to worry about them. They're all okay feelings to have.
Myself found so much comfort in feeling.
Yeah. So remember, you're going to have to go through forgiveness and you're going to have to go through repentance. And if you keep receiving God's love, you'll go through those pretty naturally. You're going to have to face up to some truth about your life. And you'll probably want to help others once you've gone through some of these things yourself. All of that's fine. God will keep showing you if you let God show you.
Yeah, I don't want to be a cause of harm.
No.
Anymore.
No. Because if you cause harm, it just is terrible to yourself and to other people.
If we can stop harm.
It creates this cycle of violence.
Yeah, I didn't know how bad that was.
Yeah. And it creates a cycle of violence that continues and is continually perpetuated on earth. It's always this cycle of violence. And you see it a lot occurring between men and women, don't you? Where men harm women harm men harm women, women harm men, and so forth and so forth. And it just keeps going around and around and around in a great big circle unless somebody stops it. And the way to stop it is by feeling your own pain rather than hurting another person. That's the way to stop it. Well, I love you, Grace.
Love you too.
Yeah.
And I'm glad I never harmed you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
I feel I need to just let you go and cry now, because there's a lot of crying you need to do. You remember you got your spirit friend Jose, who's going to be with you if you need him. So.
Yes.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's my pleasure.
All the loves that I will develop.
Yeah, there's a lot of love available. It's just a matter of whether you let yourself receive it now.
Mm. Yeah, and I want to thank God too.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah. Bye, Grace.
Bye-bye.